Please remain standing. The call to worship. Psalm number 146, verse 1 and 2. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, O my soul. While I live, I will praise the Lord. I will sing praises to my God while I have my being.
我们今天的宣教是在诗篇146篇1到2节，我们一起来读：你们要赞美耶和华，我的心啊，你要赞美耶和华，我一生要赞美耶和华，我还活的时候要歌颂我的神。
The hymn of praise is number 203, softly and tenderly.
我们一起来唱归家。
Take a moment of prayer.
我们仍然站立，让我们一起低头祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father, as we start our new year, may all your children be filled with grace this beautiful day.
我们在天上的父，当我们开启我们这新的一年，愿你所有的子女有从你而来满满的恩典。
As we start our new year, may we start each Sunday like we are in our own home, a house full with love, caring, and understanding.
在这个新的一年里面，让我们每一个主日就像我们在家里一样，充满了关爱，充满了平安。
A home in which you, our Heavenly Father, is in our midst.
这个家像我们家一样，我们在天的父，你在我们当中。
For you, dear Lord, taught us everything and on how to conduct ourselves.
主啊，你也教训我们所有的事情从你而来，也让我们教导我们怎样的行事为人。
Amen.
Emily and I share each day full with gratitude. Yes, our thankfulness for all so many things, our health, our family, our brothers and sisters here at Bethany Church.
我和Emily 每天我们也充满了感恩，我们的健康，我们的家庭和我们在真光教会里面所有的弟兄姐妹。
For you, Almighty God, has shown great kindness to us. We are humbled.
我们在天上全能的神，你给我们诸多的恩典，我们也要满心感谢赞美你。
To reflect on the present, our thoughts are.To have fully given us a full life here on earth.
然而我们现在是要感恩的，也是你在这个地上，你给了我们一个完全的生命。
We now have a virus we hope to conquer, but there are, as Pastor said, might be many more variants.
我们现在也有病毒，我们也想战胜它，就如牧师说的。但是这病毒也有非常多的变异。
I hesitate. I say, be what it may. I trust in you, Holy Father.
虽然我没有不一定能向前，但是靠着你的力量，我们在天上的神，我们能向前。
O Holy Spirit, tell us here on earth, it is just a stopover.We will continue to be with thee, O Father.
圣灵也和我们说话说，这只是我们在这短暂的世上的一站，我们必将和你在永远里面相见。
We see your glory, we see your home, to be with thee in the future someday.
我们看到你的荣耀，我们看到我们在天上的家，我们至终会和你相遇。
Our hearts, our minds are yours, O Father.
我们的心思意念都与你同在，我们在天上的父。
May you hear our prayer through Jesus Christ our Redeemer.
愿你借着我们主耶稣基督能聆听到我们的祷告，我们的祷告是蒙恩的，罪人奉主的圣名求的。
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
大家请坐。
It is offering time. Please give generously.
现在是奉献的时候。
起立，我们唱三一颂。
Please stand, let's sing the doxology.
Thank you.
赞美你。
Our Father in heaven, we thank you and we praise you.
我感谢你让我们有生命气息。
We thank you that you still are letting us live and giving us the breathing breath.
让我们可以在这个地上存活。
So that we may still live on this earth.
我感谢你也赐给我们有你丰富的供应。
And we thank you that you have blessed us with your abundant provision.
我们现在将你赐给我们的献上一部分。
And now that all the things you have blessed us, we give you a portion of it.
愿你悦纳，也愿你祝福所有甘心乐意奉献的人。
May you accept it and bless all those that are willing to give.
我感谢你，你带领我们每一天能够平安、能够健康的度过。
And we thank you for leading our everyday life that we're in peace and we're healthy.
请你让我们不要把这一切看为单然。
And let us not take all these for granted.
也让我们能够常常存着感恩的心。
So that at all times we have a heart full of gratitude.
让我们的言语、我们的行为能够与感恩 的心相称。
So that our words and our action are worthy of the gratitude.
主啊，也求你继续的看顾我们真光教会。
Lord, may you continue to look after our Bethany Christian Church.
不管是在弗拉盛或者长岛。
No matter it's in Flushing or Lila.
不管是在这里聚集，还是在线上聚集
，Whether we're gathered here physically or online，
我们愿你的同在，一直陪伴着我们。
May your presence be with us。
也求你按照我们个人属灵的需要，你将你的话语赐给我们。
And may you give us your word according to our spiritual need。
我感谢你的带领。陈牧师今天要跟我们分享你宝贵的话语。
And we thank you for leading Pastor Chen to share with us your precious word.
主啊，求你的圣灵充满他。
May your Holy Spirit fill him.
也求你让听的人和讲的人能够同感一灵。
And may the ones that speak and the ones that listen are in the same spirit.
也让我们不仅听到，而且行道。
And let us not only be listeners, but also doers as well.
我们这时候也将我们当中身体有软弱的、有病痛的弟兄姐妹带到你的面前。
And we commit all brothers and sisters among us that are sick and that is suffering.
我们为着朱迪姐妹祷告。
We pray for Sister Judy.
Maple 姐妹祷告。
Sister Maple.
还有Harry Chung 弟兄祷告。
Brother Harry Chung.
主啊，我们当中。有年长的，有身体有软弱的，求你都一一看顾保守。
Among us that are elderly and that are weak in their body, may you look at each and every one of them.
我们也纪念阿航姐妹。
And we're in remembrance of Sister Ah Hang.
我们这时候纪念主耶稣在地上教导他的门徒这样祷告说。
And we remember what the Lord our told his disciple on our deathbed.
我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同在天上。我们日用的饮食，今天赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们跌入试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的，直到永远。
阿门。
大家请坐。
Please be seated.
Our scripture readings is from Acts chapter 18, 1 to 23.
我们的读经是在《使徒行传》18章1到23节。
After these things, Paul departed from Athens and went on to Corinth. And he found a certain Jew named Aquila, born in Pontus, who had recently come from Italy with his wife Priscilla, because Claudius had commanded all the Jews to demand from Rome, and he came to them. So because he was of the same trade, he stayed with them and worked. For his occupation, they were tent makers. And he reasoned in the synagogue every Sabbath and persuaded both Jews and the Greeks. When Silas and Timothy had come from Macedonia, Paul was compelled by the Spirit and testified to the Jews that Jesus is the Christ. But when they opposed him and blasphemized, he shook his garments and said to them, "Your blood is upon your own heads. I am clean. From now on I will go to the Gentiles." And he departed from there and entered the house of a certain man named Justus, one who worshiped God, whose house was next door to the synagogue. Then Cyprus, the ruler of the synagogue, believed in the Lord with all his household, and many of the Corinthians, hearing, believed and were baptized. Now the Lord spoke to Paul in the night by a vision. "Do not be afraid, but speak, and do not keep silent, for I am with you, and no one will attack you to hurt you, for I have many people in this city." And he continued there a year and 6 months, teaching the word of God among them. When Gallio was proconsul of Achaia, the modern Greece, the Jews with one accord rose up against Paul and brought him to the judgment seat, saying, "This fellow persuades men to worship God contrary to the law." And when Paul was about to open his mouth, Gallio said to the Jews, "If I were a matter of wrongdoing or wicked crimes, O Jews, there would be a reason why I should bear with you. But if it was a question of words and names of your own law, look to it and yourselves, for I do not want to be a judge of such matters." And he drove them from the judgment seat. Then all the Greeks took Sophenes, the ruler of this synagogue, and beat him before the judgment seat. But Gallio took no notice of these things. So Paul still remained a good while. Then he took leave to the brethren and sailed for Syria. And Priscilla and Aquaria were all with him. He had his hair cut off at Cenchrea, for he had taken a vow. And he came to Ephesus and left them there, but he himself entered the synagogue and reasoned with the Jews. When they asked him to stay longer with them, he did not consent, but he took leave of them, saying, "I must by all means keep this coming feast in Jerusalem, but I will return again to you, God willing." And he sailed from Ephesus. And when he had landed at Caesarea and gone up and greeted the church, he went down to Attica. After he had spent some of the time there, he departed and went over to the region of Galatia and Parasia, in order strengthening all the disciples. Amen.
Amen.
We are happy today to have Pastor Tang give us a sermon, and the sermon's message is Good News Strategy.
今天我们很高兴有请到陈牧师为我们分享传福音的策略。
Thank you very much for the opportunity you have given to me to share the word of God with all of us here.
谢谢大家给我这个机会来分享神的话语。
We are mindful of the ministry of Bethany in Flushing and here.
我们也把真光教会在法拉盛和长老的事工放在心上。
And we rejoice with what God is doing through a faithful servant.
我们也感谢神做的所有工。
What a privilege God has given to human beings to share the word of God.
神让人能传和分享神的话语，真是一个非常荣耀的特权。
Today I'm going to share with you from Acts chapter 18.
今天我们来分享的是在《使徒行传》十八章。
Thank God.
感谢神。
The Apostle Paul wrote 13 letters in the New Testament.
圣徒保罗在新约里面。
Maybe I shouldn't have said he wrote 13. He wrote more than 13. But only 13 were made scriptures.
他写了十三篇在新约里面，但是我估计他是写了超过十三篇。
But thank God, both the Gospel of Luke and the Acts of the Apostles were written by Dr. Luke.
但感谢神，在《使徒行传》和在路加福音。
Totally was the only Gentile among the scriptural writers.
然而在写这些经文里面，只有路加他是外邦人。
He was like you and me.
他和你和我是一样的。
I'm not a Jew.
我不是一个犹太人。
Neither are you.
你也不是一个犹太人。
We are all Gentiles.
我们都是外邦人。
Praise the Lord. The Lord gave us the word, even though we are Gentiles.
但是感谢神，神给我们他的话语，虽然我们是外邦人。
So the Lord can use all kinds of people as long as they believe in the Lord Jesus Christ.
只要人愿意相信我们的主耶稣基督，他就能使用他们。
Without further ado, we'll get into the Word of God.
我们现在来看神的话语。
You can see here the Apostle Paul and his companions.Were very energetic.
我们这里能看到使徒保罗和他的同工，他们非常有热情。
During his time, there were no airplanes, there were no trains. They either had to walk or maybe ride on donkeys.
在他们当时的年代，没有火车，没有飞机，所以他们要么就是需要走路，要不他们就是骑在驴上面。
And yet he was able to travel widely.
但是他也能行到非常远的地方。
I can't help but be very impressed by the energy that God had given to him.
神赐给他的这能力，我非常的。
Before the two, we get into the Word of God.
我们来看神的话语。
You can look at verse 1 of chapter 18 of the Acts of the Apostles. After these things, he left Athens.And went to Corinth.
我们来看《使徒行传》十八章第一节。这事以后，保罗离开了雅典，来到哥林多。
He was always on the move.
他一直在行走。
He must be very energetic.
所以他是充满力量的。
During the time when they moved, they either had to walk or at the most ride on the back of a donkey.
那时候的交通非常不方便。
So he left Athens and went to Corinth.
所以他离开了雅典，去了哥林多。
It was quite a long distance, at least more than 10 miles.
这个距离是有一段距离的，起码是超过十个迈。
And God, in His providence, allowed him to meet a certain person by the name of Aquila.
神在他的供应，让他见到了一个人，叫做亚举拉。
Let's look at verse 2.
我们来看第二节。
And he found a Jew named Aquila, a native of Pontus, having recently come from Italy with his wife Priscilla, because Claudius had commanded all the Jews to leave Rome. He came to them.
我们来看第二节，遇到一个犹太人名叫雅举拉，他身在本都，因为格老丢命犹太人都离开罗马，心境带着妻。
You can see for yourself the people were moving here and there, but behind the movements was God.
我们可以看到非常多的人，他去到这儿，去到那儿，但是在他们的行动后面是神。
Even the Emperor Claudius, he gave a command And he told all the Jews to leave Rome.
在国王克拉迪亚后面，他们也叫人离开罗马。
Somehow the Jewish people had a hard time during biblical days.
那在圣经的时代呢？这些犹太人他们是有一个艰难的时间。
Nonetheless, God is always in control.
但是不管怎么样，神永远是掌权的。
Nothing happens by chance, as far as God is concerned.
所有发生的事情都不是因为机遇，都是神在后面控制。
So you look at verse 3, and because he was of the same trade, he stayed with them, and they were working for by trade, they were tent makers.
我们来看第三节，他们本是制造帐篷为业，但保罗因与他们同业，就和他们同住做工。
When we look at verse 3, we see the word tent makers, and this was literally making tents.
当我们看到他们以帐篷为业，就代表他们是搭建帐篷的。
A tent is easier to build than a house.
一个帐篷比建造一个房子要简单。
Besides, a tent is usually temporary.
所以，但是呢，一个帐篷也是暂时的。
People were on the move, so they couldn't build something that's more permanent. So they built a tent, and it's very easy to put up.And very easy to put down.
因为人一直在行走，所以他们经常会搭帐篷，它非常容易搭，也非常容易拆下来。
Look at verse 4.
我们来看第十节。
The apostle Paul had a great mind.
保罗有一个非常聪明。
He knew how to argue.
他知道怎么和人辩论。
Some of us are very argumentative.
我们有些人，我们喜欢跟人家辩论。
So there are two kinds. One is a good kind. You argue from the scriptures. One you just like to argue. That's all.
然而，辩论也有两种。一种是好的辩论，是你通过用着经文和人辩论；另外一个只是你想吵架。
And for some people, it's good for their ego.
有些人对他们的自尊、
自我。
They want to impress someone else that he or she can argue better than the other person.
他们要让别人觉得他很厉害，他可以辩论和别人，然后胜过他们。
Not the Apostle Paul.
但是使徒保罗不是这样。
His purpose of arguing is to get the truth, and by the truth, people come to faith in Jesus Christ.
他辩论的目的就是要证明真理，然后通过真理让人相信主耶稣基督。
You look at verse 4 again closely.
我们再看第四节。
Trying, you see the word trying to persuade Jews and Greeks.
这写着劝化犹太人和希利尼人。
No matter what he tried, he tried.
不管他做什么，他都是想办法去劝化他们。
And God in His providence.
神也在供应他。
His people to move around.
让这些人。行走到各个地方。
Look at verse 5.
我们看第五节。
When Silas and Timothy came down from Macedonia, Paul began devoting himself completely to the word, solemnly testifying to the Jews that Jesus was the Christ.
希拉和提摩太从马其顿来的时候，保罗为道迫切，向犹太人证明耶稣是基督。
No more tent making.
他不再造帐篷。
Because his means were provided by his friends.
因为他的朋友供应他的生活。
All that he needed, that his friends provided.
所以他所需的，他的同工、他的朋友都来供应他。
Thank God, he was able to devote himself totally to the word of God.
所以感谢神，他这样就可以把他自己投入，完完全全的投入在神的话语里面。
That's why we have pastoral ministry.
这就是为什么我们有，别的事工。
In other words, the friends and colleagues provide for the pastor's needs, so that the pastor can concentrate on the word of God.
我们有同工，有兄弟姐妹来供应牧师。
And having opposition, let us not be surprised.
然而在这个位置上，我们不要惊讶。
When God works. The devil also works.
当神工作的时候，魔鬼也在工作。
So these people will use Father Devil to resist and to blaspheme the preacher and the preaching.
然而这些人就会被魔鬼所利用，他们就会阻挡和他们会污蔑他所传的这些真理。
God in His sovereignty indicated by the opposition that Paul must move on.
所以神就和保罗说，你要继续到下个地方。
Look at verse 6 again.
我们来看第六节。
But when they resisted and blasphemed,
他们
继续 he shook out his garments and said to them, "Your blood be on your own heads. I am clean." From now on, I go to the Gentiles.
他们既抗拒毁谤，保罗就抖着衣裳说：“你们的罪归到你们自己头上，或者你们的血与我无干。从今以后，我要往外邦人那里去。”
He was sensitive to the Holy Spirit's leading.
他对圣灵的带领非常敏感。
The Holy Spirit used evil people to resist the gospel, and then that allowed Paul.To say, my time is up. I must move on.
这圣灵的带领就是让这些反对保罗的，让他知道他的时间到了，他要到下一个地方去。
Look at verse 7.
我们来看第七节。
Then he left there and went to the house of a man named Titus Justus, a worshipper of God, whose house was next to the synagogue.
于是离开那里，到一个人的家中，这人名叫多尤士都，是敬拜的。神的，他的家靠近会堂。
He wasn't a Christian yet.
他还不是一个基督徒。
But he was on the way.
但是他是在变成一个基督徒的路上。
He knew partially about the God of the Bible.
他有片面的认识对圣经里面的这位神。
That's why he called it a worshipper of God.
所以他上面说是一个敬拜神的。
In other words, he was on the way to becoming a Christian.
所以说他在变成一个基督徒的路上。
He made use of the light that was given to him. God was leading him halfway, and God said, "I'm going to lead you on until you come to Christ."
他被神的光所照，他也在一半的路上，神也会继续把他带领。
Now look at verse 8.
我们看第八节。
Crispus, the leader of the synagogue, believed in the Lord with all his household, and many of the Corinthians, when they heard, were believing and being baptized when they heard. Yes, they believed and were baptized.
广会堂的基利斯布和全家都信了主，还有许多哥林多人听了就相信受洗，他们听到的福音就受洗了。
One thing very interesting about the New Testament is that when someone believed, he gets baptized by the way.
在新约里面，一个非常有意思的就是，当他们相信了，他们马上就受洗。
Very different from today.
在今天是不一样的。
Today I hear many people say, "You can believe, but don't get baptized."
今天很多人说你可以相信，但你不要去受洗。
That is not the New Testament.
但这不是新约。
The New Testament, when people believe, they get baptized.
在新约里，当人相信，他就受洗。
What is baptism?
那受浸是什么呢
？Baptism is not the amount of water. Some Say you must have a lot of water. You must have a pool.
受洗不在乎有多少水。有些人说你一定要有很多水，一个游泳池那么多。
Some say no, you just need a cup.
有些人说你只需要一杯水。
No, some people say no, you don't need a cup. You just use your hand.
有些人说你一杯水都不需要，你用你的手就行了。
That doesn't mean baptism at all.
但是这不代表受洗的意义。
There's one word for baptism.
受洗有一个词。
That is identification.
这就是你的身份。
When a person is baptized, God prescribes water, but you are identified with the Lord Jesus Christ, and you are identified from the world.
当你
认同，
当你受洗了，你就被神所认同，你也从这个世界分别出来。
I hope everyone here is baptized.
我希望每个人在这里都已经受洗了。
If you have not been baptized, I will recommend that you do if you already believe in Jesus Christ.
如果你还没有受洗，那我非常的鼓励你赶紧接受神受洗。
Look at verse 9.
我们看第九节。
And the Lord said to Paul in the night by a vision. Do not be afraid any longer, but go on speaking and do not be silent.
夜间主的异象，主在异象中对保罗说：“不要怕，只管讲，不要闭口。”
Let's not forget, this was the great apostle Paul.
我们不要忘记这个是伟大的使徒保罗。
We would think that the apostle Paul had no fear.
我们可能想象保罗没有任何惧怕。
But he was a human being.
但我们知道他是一个人类，他有惧怕。
Fear of opposition, fear of persecution.
他惧怕那些和他敌对的，他也惧怕下监。
In other words, let us remind ourselves, though he was a great apostle, he was a human being.
所以我们要提醒我们自己，虽然他是一个伟大的使徒，但是他也是人。
Human beings have fears.
人就有惧怕。
But thank God, the Lord set in and encouraged him.
但是感谢神，主向他说话显明。
God said, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. But go on speaking and do not be silent. He said two times.
神就对他说：“不要怕，只管讲，不要闭口。”
Why?
为什么呢？
God said, "I will be with you. I will be the one to encourage you."
因为神说：“我会与你同在，我也会鼓励你。”
I will protect you. I will protect you in such a way that nobody can attack you.
我也会保护你，保护你到一个地步，没有人能攻击你。
Look at verse 10. That's what it says. Verse 10 says, "For I'm with you, and no man will attack you in order to harm you."The guarantee of protection.
第十节，有我与你同在，没有人，必没有人下手害你。
Because there are many people who have yet to hear the gospel and believe, and there are many believers which I have already earmarked.
因为还有非常多的人还没有听到福音并且相信，同时也有非常多的百姓在城里已经相信了。
When the verse said, "I have many people in this city," doesn't mean there was a big crowd. No, it doesn't mean that.
当后半段说，因为在这城里我有许多的百姓。
What is meant is that I have many people whom I call the elect. Those people, when they hear the gospel, they will believe.
因为他在城里面有非常多的已经蒙呼召的，当他们听到福音的时候，他们就会相信。
That was a great encouragement to the Apostle Paul.
这对使徒保罗来说是一个非常大的鼓励。
How do we know?
我们怎么知道呢？
How do we know that he was encouraged?
我们怎么知道他被鼓励了到被鼓励到了呢？
Verse 11 tells us.
十一节和我们说。
Verse 11 said, because of his encouragement that he received from the Lord, he stayed there for 1.5 years.
十一节说，因为前面神鼓励他，保罗就在那里住了1年零6个月。
That's a long time.
1年零6个月是一个很长的时间。
God worked in mysterious ways because the congregation, the people who have come to faith in Christ, needed to be fed, needed to be nurtured.
神的，所以说神的工作是神秘的，为神做事的人和教会都会得到神的供应。
Again, you see the opposition in verse 12.
然后我们在十二节又看到。
While Gallio was proconsul of Achaia, the Jews who won the court rose up against Paul and brought him before the judgment seat. They were determined to get rid of him.
在加流做亚该亚方伯的时候，犹太人同心起来攻击保罗，拉他到公堂。
By all means, by hook or by crook, they wanted to get rid of him.
他们要通过所有手段把使徒保罗给除掉。
And they falsely accused him. And look at verse 13.
然而十三节他们就回报他。
This man persuades men to worship God contrary to the law. This was a false accusation.
十三节说，这个人劝人不按着律法敬拜神。
Paul never did that.
保罗从来没有这样干过。
Paul obeyed the law.Paul obeyed the law of God and the law of man.
保罗顺服神，保罗也顺服神的话语和他的诫命。
So same with us.
我们也是一样。
Don't have people tell you, "I obey God, but I don't obey man." That's not true. When we obey God, we also must obey man.
也不要让人和你说，我顺服神，但我不顺服人。
Verse 14.
十节。
But when Paul was about to open his mouth. Galileo said to the Jews, if it were a matter of wrong or a vicious crime, O Jews, it would be reasonable for me to put up with you. But if there are questions about words and names and your own law, look after it yourselves. I'm unwilling to be a judge on these matters.
保罗刚要开口，加里就对犹太人说：“你们这些犹太人，如果是为冤枉或奸恶的事物，
买
刀而耐听你们。”
I think Galileo was a wise man.
我觉得加里是一个有智慧的人。
He was a wise man because he knew what to be involved and what not to be involved.
他是一个有智慧的人，因为他知道什么事情他可以参与，什么事情他不能参与。
Anything which he felt wasn't of concern to him, he said, "Do it yourself. I don't want to be involved."
当他感觉这件事与他无关的时候，他就说：“这是你们的事情，我不要参与。”
Verse 16. And he drove them away from the judgment seat. He said, "Please get away. Don't bother me. I have lots of things to do."
第十六节说。这样的事我不愿审问，就把他轰出公堂。
This is one of the things we need to learn.
这是我们需要学习的。
Anything that doesn't involve us, anything is of no concern to us, don't get involved.
很多事情和我们没有关系，我们不需要参与，那我们就不要去参与。
We are all limited.
我们都是有限的。
We have only 8 hours a day where we do our work.8 hours we sleep, and then 8 hours we eat.
我们一天只有8个小时工作，8个小时睡觉，剩下的时间我们休息。
Anyway, when the evil starts to work, they will do all they could to oppose the truth of God.
然而，当邪恶的开始，邪恶的那位开始工作，他就会用尽一切来抵挡神。
So they took hold of Sosthenes. Verse 17.
所以十七节便揪住管会堂的索提尼。
And they all took hold of Sosthenes, the leader of the synagogue, and began beating him in front of the judgment seat. But Galileo was not concerned about any of these things.
所以他们就揪住管会堂的索提尼，在堂前打他。然而这些事，加流都不管。
So the opposers of the true gospel resort to violence.
所以这些抵挡他们的人就开始用暴力。
They couldn't win by argument, so they use force.
他们在辩论上他们赢不了，他们直接就动手。
They use violence. They started beating him.
他们就用暴力开始打他。
Verse 18.
18.
Paul, having remained many days longer, took leave of the brethren and put out to sea for Syria. And with him were Priscilla and Aquila in Cenchrea. He had his hair cut, for he was keeping a vow.
保罗又住了多日，就辞别了弟兄，坐船往叙利亚去。百基拉、雅居拉和他同去。他因为许过愿，就在间隔里剪了头发。
In New Testament times, people took their vows very seriously.
在新约里面，人答应的话，他们非常起誓，他们非常遵守。
Anything he had vowed, he wanted to make sure that he fulfilled the vow.
所以，当他们起誓或者许愿，他们就会遵守。
We move to verse 19.
十九节。
They came to Ephesus.And he left them there. Now he himself entered the synagogue and reasoned with the Jews.
十九节到了以弗所，保罗就把他们留在那里，自己进了会堂和犹太人辩论。
Why did he do that?
他为什么要这样做呢
？He loved the Jews.
因为他爱这些犹太人。
He loved his own people.
他爱他的同族的人。
He wanted to convince them of the truth of the gospel.The truth of Jesus Christ the Messiah.
他要让他们相信真理，相信这位弥赛亚。
This is not a racial statement. It is a statement of identification.
这不是一个种族的话语，这是一个辨别的。
So if we Chinese people.
认同。
We want to reach out to the Chinese people. There's nothing wrong.
所以，当我们要对我们中国人来传福音，没有任何错。
Well, because it's easier in the sense that we have the language, we have the culture.
因为对我们来说，可能这样更简单，因为我们有。
We have the understanding.
我们有相同的语言，相同的文化。
So it was a reasonable thing.
所以这是一个合理的事情。
Okay, verse 20.
二十五节。
When they asked him to stay for a longer time, he did not consent.
当众人请他多住些日子，他没有允许。
Paul was clear about his agenda.
保罗知道他的使命。
Paul was directed by God himself, so he knew that he must move on.
因为神在带领保罗，保罗知道他需要到下一个地方。
He said to himself that I must not get distracted. I must move on as the Holy Spirit wants me to move on.
他就和自己说，我不要受拦阻，我要。
On the other hand, he was very skillful.
我要跟从圣灵的带领。
In other words, he didn't want to, what you call, completely ignore the people who were concerned about him. He said, "If God willing, I will come back to you."
但是他也不要不理那些留他的人，所以他说，如果神带领，我就回来。
Verse 21.
二十一节。
That's a beautiful verse.
这是一个非常美的境界。
Yes, we do not want to be too rough on our friends.
我们要。对我们的弟兄姐妹有爱。
Those friends who want you to come back, we don't say, "No, I'm not going to come back." No, you say, "If the Lord wills, I will come back."
那些要让你再回来的，我们不能直接拒绝他说我不回来。我们要说，神如果愿意，就把我带来。
Let God lead us.
让神带领我们。
Be gentle.
我们要对他们温柔。
Be gentle in our relationship with one another.
我们在彼此的关系，我们也要温柔对待。
Be gracious。
我们也要珍惜。
Be kind。
我们也要大度。
In human relations, let's not be rough。
所以在人和人关系之间，我们不能粗暴的对付。
Look at verse 22。
我们看二十二节。
When he had landed at Caesarea, he went up and greeted the church, and went down to Antioch.
在该撒利亚下船，就上耶路撒冷去问教会安，随后下安提阿去。
Thank God, he loved the church.
感谢神，他爱教会。
Whenever he was led to a church that he had relationship with, he wanted to greet them.
每当他到一个教会他有关系的，他就过去问安。
And that was what he did.
这也是他所行的。
Yes, even though it was.A short time with them, he greeted them.
虽然他在那儿的日子待的是短暂的，但是他还是和他们问安。
He never ignored them.
他从来没有忽略他们。
We do not like to be ignored.
没有人希望被忽略。
Let us say you have a friend.
当我说你有个朋友。
And your friend comes to your city.
你的朋友来到了你的城市。
What do you think of him if he knows that you stay there and you just move on?
如果他在那儿没有来见你，你会有什么感觉
？At least he must come and say, "Hey, I'm here. Let's say hello. Let's have a lunch together."
所以当他到了，他到的时候，他肯定要和你打招呼，一起出来吃个饭。
So this is called human relations.
这就是人与人之间的关系。
Verse 23.
二十三节。
And having spent some time there, he left and passed successively to the Galatian region and Phrygia.Strengthening all the disciples.
住了一些日子，又离开那里，挨次经过加拉太和弗吕加地方，兼顾众门徒。
When God gave him the opportunity, he made use of the opportunity to encourage the believers, to strengthen the believers.
当神给他这个机会，他也善用神给的这个机会。
He never ignored the believers.
他鼓励和兼顾那些门徒。
That's a lesson for us.
他从来没有冷落他们。
If you go to a certain city and you know of somebody you know who was a Christian, you don't ignore him. You stop by and at least say hello.
所以这也是给我们的一个教训。当我们来到一个城市，我们有弟兄姐妹，我们不能忽略他，要和他们打招呼。
Even better, invite him to have lunch.
更好的就是和他出去吃个饭。
And ask about him ask about his family, ask about the church that he goes to.
然而关心他的教会，他的家人。
可是 you notice, one of the things I do not like to say is your church, my church. I say no, the church you go to, the church you sit in.
所以大家也可能知道，我很不喜欢说你的教会或我的教会，我喜欢说你去的教会。
Thank God, we belong to the church. The church doesn't belong to us.
所以感谢神，我们是属于教会的，教会并不属于我们。
That's a great difference.
这是一个非常大的区别。
We belong to the church. The church doesn't belong to us.
我们是属于教会的，但是教会不是属于我们的。
Verse 24.
二十四节。
Now a Jew, named Apollos, an Alexandrian by birth, an eloquent man, came to Ephesus.And he was mighty in the scriptures. Verse 24.
Okay.
有一个犹太人名叫亚波罗来到以弗所，他身在亚历山大，是有学问的，最能讲读圣经。
Alexandrian by birth. Now this particular place is in North Africa, so he was an African.
这个时候他身在亚历山大，就是当时的北非洲，所以他是非洲人。
Now he wasn't, or what you call a black African, or a white African, we do not know, the Bible doesn't tell us.
那至于他的肤色是黑的还是白的，我们不知道，因为圣经没有和我们说。
But God had greatly gifted him. He was a good speaker.
但是神给他非常大的恩赐，他是一个非常好的讲员。
That's why you have this in the Word of God here, an eloquent man.
所以在圣经里面说他是有学问的。
Came to Ephesus and he was mighty in the Scriptures. He was a good speaker. He also knew the Word of God.
来到以弗所，最能讲解圣经。他不但有好的口才，他也非常理解圣经。
Even though he knew the Scriptures.His knowledge was partial.
虽然他知道圣经，但是他的智慧是有限的。
Verse 25.
二十五节。
This man had been instructed in the way of the Lord, and being fervent in spirit, he was speaking and teaching accurately the things concerning Jesus, being acquainted only with the baptism of John.
这人已经在主的道上受了教训，心里火热，将耶稣的事详细讲论教训人，只是他单晓得约翰的洗礼。
You can see here, the Bible tells us like it is.
所以通过圣经的字面，我们就知道
，highly gifted, but knowledge was partial.
他很有恩赐，但是。他的知识是有限的。
Thank God, he was a good speaker.
但感谢神，他是一个很好的讲员。
He was a bold speaker. He was a fearless speaker.
他也是一个大胆的讲员。
And he began to speak out boldly in the synagogue. He wasn't afraid. He wasn't afraid at all. He just spoke clearly, and he spoke to the Jews.
所以在犹太的教堂里面，他就大胆地和这些犹太人说，他没有任何惧怕。
He had two great gifts. He was a great speaker. He knew the Bible, but yet he was not perfect.
他有两个大的恩赐，他是个好的讲员，他也了解圣经。
There was a couple in the congregation.
那在会幕里面有一对人。
By the name of Priscilla and Aquila.
叫百基拉、雅居拉。
These two couples were so skillful in human relations, they didn't stand up and contradicted him while he was speaking.
这两个人就站起来反对他。
They let him speak whatever he needed to say, and then after he had spoken, they invited him to the house, and then explained to him the way of God more accurately.
所以他们就等他讲完，然后把他请到他们的家里面，来跟他说怎么样讲得更加的精准。
If he would be alive today, we would say that he must have read the book by Dale Carnegie called How to Win Friends and Influence People.
所以他如果还在世现在的话，他肯定会读那本书，怎么样赢得更多的朋友。
If you want to correct somebody who is so eloquent, you do it privately.
所以如果你要给一个很有学问的人有意见的话，你要在私底下。
So verse 26 is a great lesson on human relations.
所以二十六节就是一个非常好的教训，在人与人相处。
Verse 27. And when he wanted to go across to Achaia, the brethren encouraged him and wrote to the disciples to welcome him. And when he had arrived, he greatly helped those who had believed through grace.
他想要往亚该亚去，兄弟就勉励他，并写信请门徒接待他，或以兄弟们就写信劝门徒接待他。他到了那里，多帮助那蒙恩信主的人。
And this is one thing we need to learn.
这是我们要学习的。
We need to encourage.
我们要鼓励彼此。
Try not to be negative. Try to avoid negativism, but try to encourage.
我们要离开所有负面的，我们要相互鼓励。
There was a man.In the Acts of the Apostles, by the name of Barnabas.
在使徒里面，行传里面有个人叫 Barnabas.
巴拿巴。
Barnabas, 巴拿巴。
Actually, Barnabas was not his real name.
然而，巴拿巴不是他的真名。
Actually, his real name was Joseph.
他的真名是约翰。
约瑟。
Sorry.
But he.Was capitalized by encouraging people. Every time he meets another Christian or a group of Christians, he would encourage them.
他的个人特征就是他非常喜欢鼓励别的基督徒。
The thing is that he didn't do it once a while. He did it all the time.
而且他没有偶尔做一次，而是他每天都在做。
So much so that the believers around him said.We must give him a nickname, and we shall call him Barnabas.
所以说，他这个鼓励人做到一个地步，他周围的弟兄姐妹就给他了一个外号，叫做巴拿巴。
So I like to encourage people. If you see someone like that, give him a nickname, call him Barnabas.
所以我也鼓励大家，当你看到弟兄姐妹也这样鼓励人的时候，也给他一个外号，叫他巴拿巴。
And finally, verse 28.
28节
For he powerfully refuted the Jews in public.
在众人面前极有能力宣导犹太人。
Sometimes it is necessary to argue publicly.
有时候我们需要在公共的场所来辩论。
When privately it is not.
当在私底下没有用的时候。
When the offense is in public.We rebuke the offense publicly.
当他们在公共的会场里、公共的场所来攻击我们的时候，我们就需要回应他。
Because truth is at stake.
因为我们的真理在受到威胁。
The gospel is at stake.
我们的福音也受到了威胁。
Public mistake must be corrected publicly.
所以公开的攻击，我们要公开的回应他。
And in verse 28.We wrap it up.
第二十八节。
I'll read again verse 28. For he powerfully refuted the Jews in public, demonstrating by the scriptures that Jesus was the Christ.
在众人面前极有能力的辩倒犹太人，以圣经证明耶稣是基督。
Let us pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Father, we are thankful for your servants.
我们在天上的父，我们感谢你。
Eloquent.And fearless.
我们感谢你这位仆人，他有学问，他也是。
We thank you for blessing us with eloquence. For some of us, at least, we are eloquent, but also help us to be fearless.
我们也感谢你赐给我们属天的学问，也让我们在没有惧怕。
So that we will speak that which must be spoken.
因为给我们没有惧怕，让我们把该说的话语。从你而来的话语说出来。
Give us the courage to do so.
给我们这个胆量。
Give us grace that we may be gracious.
也给我们你的救恩，也让我们。
In Jesus' name we pray.
感谢我们在主耶稣基督得胜的名祷告。
阿门。
阿门。
in my publication. Thank you very much for the translation.
Thank you, Pastor Tang. All about Apostle Paul. Let's stand and sing Rescue the Perishing.
感谢陈牧师的分享，我们一起来唱，站立来唱，赶快救灭亡人。
Pastor
Tang,
would you please give the benediction for us?
The benediction?
Yes.
Yes. 有请陈牧师给我们。
Please stand.
从上而来的
祝
大家
虔诚。I'm
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of us until Jesus comes again. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Services will be over, and thank you for coming, and I hope to see everybody next week. After a moment of silent prayer, we will, the service is ended.
大家请默祷散会，我们下礼拜再一同聚集。